So I hope you guys enjoyed that little music thing I did there, and if you didn't, just tell me in the description below. But so I have something I want to talk about, which I'm very concerned about when it's about Mw3, and that is trickshotting in Mw3. So, you know, if you guys not paying so much attention to the YouTube community, a lot of people are actually trickshotting in Search and Destroy or Team Deathmatch. And you know, when Mw3 comes out, if people still are going to trickshot, I think that's going to ruin the game. It's okay to trickshot in Mw2 because it's 2 years old. Well, it's 1 year old and, well, 2 years old and minus 2 weeks, but yeah, so it's an old game and Mw3 is new. People are going to go objective, they're going to care about their stats, their win-loss, KD, they're going to care about things. And when people are trickshotting, well, it's not going to ruin their KD, but it's going to ruin the fun to play objective, you know? It's not fun to play objective when you have 6 morons jumping off a roof and trying to kill you with some kind of 360. Well, so that's just my opinion. If they're going to trickshot in Mw3, I think they should patch the kill cam. Of course, it's good to have the kill cam sometimes, you know, if you get a no scope. But when you do it all the time, trying for a no scope, it's just annoying when people are trickshotting. That's my opinion, you know. But well, people that are trickshotters are actually thinking that's helping the game, it's helping the community. Well, I could agree, but I just can't. I just don't see what's the point in trickshotting. And yeah, I don't have so much to talk about that subject, but no, I hope they do something that can make trickshotting patched, if you know what I mean. No, they can do something, you know, they can. People always go for 360s, of course, but they should probably like patch the fade shot or and all that tactical knife stuff people are doing, you know, when you flip it or barrel roll, you know. That's my opinion, as I've said before. I probably said that like 1,000 times now, but I have another topic, and that is when what do people think when they jump on COD or COD? What my opinion is that famous YouTubers like White Boy and people like that jump on Call of Duty mostly because they want to gameplay, you know. They earn money for playing, and if they come with a gameplay which is 38-30, they're not gonna get subs. They're not gonna get the money. Well, the first video, but if they do that, like, give people a content which is so bad, people are not gonna subscribe. And if you don't have a YouTube channel or a HDPVR, you jump on the game because you wanna have fun, you know, wanna play. Probably because you're bored, done with homework or home from school, or just wanna play, you know. And you know, like White Boy, his KD win loss is 0.13, something like that. It's terrible, and you know why? Because he's raging, and when he rage, when he's like starting a game, get killed 3 times in a row, he's raging because he thinks this cannot be a gameplay, and that's what he's thinking in his mind. And if he didn't have that had a famous YouTube channel, he would have kept on playing, unless he was pissed off of something. But This commentary is actually coming to end, so hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'm bye. I'm out.